So here's the extension cord that goes to my computerized mouse trap monitoring system. And I've got a light on here, and I've got my Raspberry Pi, and there's a camera module right there aimed at the mouse trap. And here's the console for my mouse trap monitoring system. So if I just reach in there, as soon as there's my finger in there, you can see there's motion detection logged, and those images were saved. And I took the water out of this one just because I don't want to show mice getting killed on YouTube.
The idea with this kind of trap is that the mouse eventually gets on the can to get at the bait, and the can rotates, and the mouse falls in a bucket and drowns. But as you can see, the mouse is very good at avoiding getting onto that can and falling in, and it's still getting at some of the bait. We've used this sort of trap to catch mice many times before, but it's clear that this trap is not working optimally.
It looks like that mouse is just too darn clever, so I have to build a better mouse trap. So I put little stones in this one, so this one's actually fairly stable, and I'm hoping the mouse will trust it enough to actually walk across it. So when it gets to this one, hopefully it'll just fall in and it won't have anything to grab by.
So the can is stable enough to hold the mouse, and let's see here. Oh, gotcha! Haha! So the mouse then spent over an hour trying to get out of that bucket, but it did manage to jump out eventually. And what do you know, it just goes right back at it. Come on, fall, fall! Damn. I gotta really admire the daring and the agility of that mouse. It's just amazing. Strike two! Whoa, that was much quicker getting out of the bucket this time. There it goes again. Looks like the weighted can actually is pretty good on its own. Better than one that rotates freely. And here we go, at it again. And let's see. Come on, come on, come on, fall. Okay, so again, it fell off the weighted can, not the freely spinning one.
I guess that trap works as long as the mice are hungry enough, but I want to build something to catch them while they're still cautious. I was figuring some kind of counterweighted tilting ramp like this. Eventually, it loses its balance. Except this ramp is kind of heavy, it's made out of metal, and I figure as the ramp tilts, the mouse could still scurry back. So what I've come up with is this thing, which is a very light ramp. It's just a piece of wood with some plastic on there so that the mouse can't really claw into it. And it tilts on here. There's a bolt back here for counterweight. And I want this to actually dump kind of unexpectedly. So there's a little magnet on the back and a piece of wire sticking out here so that as the mouse gets on here, eventually it just lets go and dumps the mouse suddenly. Slowly taking the bait and there's no warning. Everything is very stable.
With the magnet weakening as it gets further away from it, once it starts to tip, it'll really tip. Yeah, there it goes. And this was followed by a better part of an hour of the mouse trying to jump back out. You gotta admire the stamina of these things. And here we go, right back at it. Ta-da! It's out. Oh, not out for very long this time. Looks like that mouse is starting to wisen up to my trap. Of course, if I'd put water in it, it would have been dead several times over. It's funny how many times that mouse falls in the same bucket. This is actually pretty cool because if it was a different mouse each time, I could really catch an awful lot of mice with this trap without significantly depleting the bait. Thank you. Looks like this mouse has learned to hang onto the ramp as it starts to tip so it doesn't fall into the bucket every time. So all these clips with the tipping ramp were actually recorded over the course of a week. And later in the week, the mouse actually no longer went onto the ramp, so it learned eventually that it's just no good going on there.
So this one works super well, and it could be made slightly more effective by making the edges of the ramp harder to grab. But realistically, the weighted can is very effective on its own already, and even a freely spinning can will work. So this is much easier to make, and I'd recommend you go with that. And the weight I had in the can is about 40 grams.